Hi everybody, welcome to our new Worldstream video. My name is Remi and I'm your host. We're going to tell you about our 10 terabit network backbone together with Sander. So if you please follow me. Sander is your media network engineer. We're standing before two routers. What kind of routers are these?
These are aggregation routers here on one of our four floors in Naaldwijk.
And what's an aggregation router?
An aggregation router, as the name suggests, is aggregates all the traffic coming in from all of our top of rack switches located in the racks. And all of the traffic coming in from the racks is aggregated on this router, which is the first step in the chain of getting our customers' traffic to the internet.
Okay, great. Why do we have two aggregation routers?
Good question. This is done for redundancy reasons. To achieve this multi-router redundancy, we're making use of Arista MLAP. By using this, we ensure to keep downtime to a minimum, even in case of something like a router failure.
Okay, great. And you mentioned core routers. Can we see the core routers?
Sure, let's go take a look at those.
Okay.
All right, here we are at one of our core routers here in Naaldwijk. This is basically where everything comes together. All the traffic from our aggregation routers, of which we were just at, comes in here and then is distributed further. It can either be sent directly via one of our transit links connected here, or carried further throughout our network to one of our edge routers. We have multiple edge routers located in the Netherlands and Frankfurt, and each of those edge routers has around 2 terabits of connectivity with our core routers.
Okay, 2 terabytes sounds like a lot of bandwidth. Why do we need so much?
Yeah, it definitely sounds like a lot, but we also definitely needed. This is not only to accommodate all of our customers' traffic, but also to ensure that we keep a maximum of 45% utilization on all of our links at all time. So in case we ever face something like a router failure or a failover, then we still have enough capacity to accommodate all of the traffic and cause no congestion on our links.
Okay. And you also mentioned edge routers. What are edge routers?
Yeah, those edge routers, like I said, are located in various data centers in the Netherlands and Frankfurt. And those edge routers, we use them to connect to as many networks as possible. So those edge routers have as their function to distribute our customers' traffic further out onto the internet. And by connecting to as many other providers and connections as possible, we ensure to have the best routes for all of our customers.
Okay, and also, how do you get a multi-terabyte connection on one fiber? How do you make that possible?
Yeah, that is achieved by using our DWM, which we see here.
Where is the DWM and what does it do?
So yeah, we have our DWM appliance right here. This is used for sending multiple terabytes of traffic over a single dark fiber. So for instance, to our edge router locations. This is done by assigning each of the links to the edge router a different frequency. All these frequencies are then sent over the single dark fiber. And then at the edge router location in the data center, we also have a DWDM setup exactly like this one. There we receive the dark fiber again, and all the different frequencies are then divided, and all the subsequent links are then connected to the edge router again.
Okay, and is the DWDM also redundant?
Yes, definitely. Those dark fibers that I mentioned, we have 2 of them running to each edge router. One of the dark fibers is either passive and the other one is active. The active one is currently being used, traffic is going over it, and the passive one is not being used. And say that, for instance, something happens to the active dark fiber, like road work, digging, something like that, the system, the DWDM appliance will detect that. We will have a subsequent failover to the passive dark fiber without causing any impact to our customers' traffic.
Okay, nice. Okay, Sander, thank you for your detailed explanation.
Yeah, you're very welcome, Remi.
Thanks for watching this video. If you liked the video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe. See you on the next one.